So students, finally we have come to the last part of this first chapter of politics in India since independence, and we, as we were talking in the last lecture about the reorganization of states, we had also talked about the formation of Andhra, which was basically done on the linguistic principles. Why? Because the people had come up to protest, and finally the Prime Minister had to announce the formation of Andhra as a separate province. So this formation of Andhra was a very historic thing. Why? Because it spurred a series of struggle which initiated the making of other states also on the linguistic line. And as a result, the formation of so many states on the linguistic line finally forced the central government to appoint the State Reorganization Commission in 1953. Now this commission looked into the question of redrawing of state boundaries. Moreover, in its report, it also accepted that boundaries of the states should reflect the boundaries of different languages. And it was this report of the State Reorganization Commission that, because of which, the State Reorganization Act was passed in 1956. And this act led to the creation of 14 states and 6 union territories. So finally we could say the linguistic principle only became the basis of the formation of state. But as the leaders had feared that linguistic principles will lead to fostering of separatism, and finally the states will get self-reliant and will move away from the concept of unity. But this all fears proved baseless, and today, after so many years of independence and so many years of the formation of the states on the basis of linguistic principles, we have come to realize that linguistic formation of states on the basis of language did not create any kind of separatism. In fact, it strengthened the concept of India and its unity, and has led to the formation of the Indian Union the way it is today. So with this we come to the formation, come to the end of the first chapter, where we had talked about three things: the partition of India, the integration of the princely states, and finally the reorganization of states. Before I sum up with this today's lecture, I would like to reiterate to the children that you have to do all the questions which are given in the NCERT, which includes match the following questions, read the passage and answer on the basis of it, and various other questions. Because in class 12, we have questions of different categories, which include the multiple choice questions, which are based on the text which is given in your books. Along with it, you have passage based questions, and there are also picture based questions. But along with the NCERT, these are a set of questions which I would like you to attempt in your notebooks and write these questions in detail, so that you get to revise the entire chapter at one go. Question number 1, analyze any 6 consequences of the partition of India in 1947. Question number 2, what forced the Union Government of India to set up the State Reorganization Commission in 1953? Mention its 2 main recommendations. Name any 4 states formed after 1956. Explain briefly the 3 challenges faced by India at the time of its independence. These are the same challenges which I explained in the first lecture. Explain the circumstances that led to the accession of Hyderabad to India. This you will deal with the entire series of events that finally led to the formation, to the joining of Hyderabad to India. Then the accommodation of regional demands and the formation of linguistic states were also seen as more democratic. Justify the statement. You will justify this statement on the basis of the formation of the Andhra state, as well as to show that use of linguistic principles has helped in strengthening the unity of the country. And finally, how was the princely state of Manipur acceded to India? So with this, we come to the end of the first chapter. In the next lecture, we will be continuing with chapter 2nd of the book 1st, that is contemporary world politics, and the chapter will be end of bipolarity. Till then, keep staying, keep studying, and keep connected.